All right, so what are my thoughts on Nas's follow-up, Streets Disciple? What's going on, ladies and gents in Cyberland? Coming back with another album review from that man, Nas. Streets Disciple. So, with this album, Nas, this is the second time he's released a double album. I mean, some people say it's the first, but I disagree. And at this point, Nas was dating Khalees, and this album kind of reflected on his relationship with her, his relationship with the street life, being a parent, trying to reach the adolescence years. But also, it was starting to become more political, too, because Nas was starting to focus on the fact that the people that we hold in high regard be doing some outlandish shit, and we need to start holding people that are really not squeaky clean, because everybody makes mistakes, but people that are trying to make a difference in the community and trying to improve it, those are the people we need to hold in high regard, not celebrities. So that was one thing that really struck a chord with me with this album. Besides that, Nas also gives honorable mention to his dad, as well as, you know, he brings up a little bit about his mom and such too. So that was interesting to hear. However, this album kind of came off rather bloated. Some of the tracks just felt like filler. Overall, the album kind of felt to me like he probably should have made this a single track album as opposed to a double. It, as opposed to how I Am was, this album just felt like it had elements of a direction, but then at other times it kind of be like the direction wasn't as cohesive, I guess you could say. It's not a bomb nonetheless. I give it an 8 out of 10 yes sirs. I just feel like how it starts off good, but then it kind of deviates a little bit. The production wasn't too much of an eyesore for me. Lyrics weren't the problem. It just felt like there was just too many tracks and they didn't hit as much as, you know, Godson or you know, Stillmatic. But the one thing I've noticed about hip-hop is that it's hard to do double albums. It's very rare where you come across a hip-hop album where it's a double album and everything is great. Some people will disagree with that, of course. But in general, it doesn't seem like it's easy to do as more so as maybe it's a rock record. But I don't know. I don't dislike the album. I enjoyed it for what it was. It just felt like it was too much than what it should have been. Take it or leave it kind of thing. As far as my top tracks, I would say, of course, Bridging the Gap. And for most people, that if you've seen Creed, that's where that song is. That's where you would see it. Nazareth Savage definitely was, for production, that was something different for me than I had heard previously. So that was a huge thing for me and what I really liked about this album. That track in particular, Streets Disciple, War, and Thief's Theme. The only song I kind of... it didn't really work for me. I don't really care for it, but it's not that bad. It at first I hated the song. Now I can tolerate it. It's not a I don't care for track. It's just it was borderline where it was gonna stay in there. But American way. I think the beat doesn't work for what Nas is trying to get across. And I don't know. I guess having Khalees on it, there might have been a reason behind it or something. I just, I don't know if those two work well on tracks together. I it didn't hit for me. But otherwise, a good album nonetheless, just rather bloated. So, I would say, this album is more so if you like Nas and you've gotten a couple albums under your belt with him, then you listen to this. I wouldn't say this would be one of the first go-to albums to do. I'd say get a couple albums under your belt and then check this out as opposed to starting right away. So with that, cue the music.
Let's go! I'm the magnificent. Hey, Chuck Berry of this rap skit. Styles I mastered, many brothers snatched it up and tried to match it, but I'm still number one, everyday real. Speak what I want, I don't care what y'all feel, cause I'm my own master. My pop told me be your own boss, keep integrity at every cost, and his home was Natchez, Mississippi. Did it like Miles and Dizzy, now we getting busy, bridging the gap from the blues to jazz to rap. The history of music on this track. Born in the game, discovered my father's music like Prince searching through boxes of Purple Rain. But my Minneapolis was the bridge, home of the super kids. Some are well known, some doing bids. I might have ended up on the wrong side of the tracks if Pops wouldn't have pulled me back and said, yo, yo.
See, I come from Mississippi. I was young and running wild. Ended up in New York City,
New York,
where I had my first child.
That's me, y'all.
I named the boy Nasir.